Hi, good morning. In this tutorial, we will learn how to display the tabular data using HTML table tag. So here we discussed about the HTML tables here. The HTML tables, so here HTML table allows you to arrange the data in rows and columns. Here they commonly use it to display the tabular data like product list, like we can use the customer details. Like this, we can give the tabular HTML tables. This table is used to store the data. So here we can create the tables using the table element. So here, this is a table element. We can create this table using table tag. So after that, the table we having tr. Tr indicates, tr stands for table row here. Tr is a stands for table row, and this table having the table data inside of a row, we can keep the data here. So we can use td. Td stands for table data. Sometimes we can use the th also. Th indicates that table head here. How do you create the table here? So creating a table is very easy. So using this table tag close. So instead of table, we can give here the tr and tr close. So inside of the tr, we can write the table data here. Okay, here we can write the table data. So like this, we can create the table in the HTML. So the table in the HTML stands for, like, it will store the data here. Now we just open this Visual Studio. We just see the example for this table here. So how can you create the table? So here I'm just creating the basic table here. Now we just created a program here. I'm just saving the program. So here I'm just saving with table.html. This is a HTML table. So for this HTML table, just created this one. So here I'm just giving this title here. So I'm just giving the title HTML table. Now we need to create a table here. For this HTML, we need to create table here. So for this table, so here we just create a table here. I'm just creating a table. So table close. After the table, we need to give, so here tr, and inside of that we can give the td here. Look at this one. So we just created the table. If you run this one on the browser, see, nothing will display here. Why? Because we just created the table itself. So we just created the table itself, but we didn't give the borders, but we didn't give the height and width for the tables here. So look at this one here. So we can give the height and width and border. How can you take this border and height and width for these tables here? Here, look at this one. I'm just writing the border. So border, I'm just giving the border 2 pixels. Next, we having, I'm just giving the width. So width equal to, I'm just giving the width as 300. 400, I'm just giving the width as 400. I'm taking the height. So here I'm taking the height like 400. For width and height 400. Now you can give the border as 2, right? I'm just reduce it to 1 here. Now you can refresh on this browser. So there you got the table here. So look at this one. There you got the table here. Like this, we can having the basic table here. I just reduce this table of width 200. I reduce the height also 200. So what will happen if you give the border as 2 here? See, if you give the 2, they will give the 2 lines of borders. See, look at this one. So if you refresh this one, see, there you get the thickness here. So if you give the 5 pixels, so look at this one. If you refresh this one, so there you get the thick color border like this. So there you get the thick color border like this. So look at this one. So this is a table tag. So here we just give the H1 basic table. So basic table. Here I'm taking the basic table. So for this basic table, just give it here. So they're having the TR and TD here. Look at this one. Very first this one. So the basic table indicates that this is a whole data will be table data, and this one is called, this is called table row here. Like this, the table have the structure in the HTML. Look at this one. We just created the table here. We just created the table. In the table, so we need to create multiple rows and multiple columns. So here, how do you create the multiple rows and multiple columns in the table? Look at this one. So we're just creating the only one row here. Next, we have to take so multiple rows and columns. So here I'm taking this H1. So here we just take the multiple. Multiple rows and columns. Multiple rows and columns. For this multiple rows and columns, we just take the table here. So here I'm taking the table. Inside of table, we just create in the tr. So tr and td. So we just creating the td here. Look at this one. So we just created a table. Table here. And tr here. Now see, look at this one. If you run this one on the browser, there you get same output. So here first we need to give, see, I'm just giving for this table, we need to give the border. We need to set the border here. So I'm setting this border equal to, so we can give the 3 here. After that, we just give height and width here. We just give the height. So height I'm taking the 400. And just we can take 300 itself, not a problem. So here we just give the width as 300. So width I'm taking the 300. So we can also take the height and width using the style tag also. So here I'm just taking the height and width. Now we can refresh this one on the browser. Just we can refresh this one. Look at this one. They're having multiple rows and multiple columns as a heading, but here the table having only one row itself. So we need to create few more rows. So for creating the rows here, look at this one. We just copy this TRs, just copy this TRs and paste it here. So look at this one and paste it. Here I'm taking the 2 TRs. Now I'm taking the 3 TRs. Look at this one. If you refresh this one on the browser, if you refresh this one on this, so there you get the multiple rows here. Multiple rows here. So here for this multiple rows. So here we need to add multiple columns also. Look at these columns. Columns are taken as a TDs here. So for this TD, so here we have a TDs, right? So each row having only one TD itself. So here we just give one more TD here. I'm taking the copy as one more TD. So here also I'm taking one more TD. So here also I'm taking one more TD here. Now you can refresh this one. So here I'm just taking one more TD. Now we can refresh this one on the browser. Look at this one. So first we having only rows here. We just refresh this one on the browser. So look at this one. They're having the one column here, one column. So like each row having two TDs, like two table data. See here, they're having the three rows on each row having two TDs. So we need to add one more column. So we need to add one more column. So here we just copy this column. So we just take the TDs here. I just copy this TD also. The down, we just go here and we can copy this one. So here we just copy this one. If you run this one on the browser, there you get one more column. So here we just refresh this one on the browser. Look at this one. So there you get the two columns. So there you get two columns here. Like this, we can create this. So like this, we can create the multiple rows and columns in the tables here. Now, so for this table, so we just create the table. We just created the table rows, columns here. Look at this one. So here, I need to spanning the columns. We need to span the columns. Spanning means we can adjust it. We can mix the two columns. We can mix the table two rows. So here for spanning of the columns on rows here. So look at this one. The table we having call span and row span here. These two
call span and row span.
These two, we have these two attributes. These two attributes in the tables, having that, it tells the tables, like we can span the two columns, we can span the two rows using this call span and row span here.
So look at this one. So I'm just open this Visual MS Paint here. I'm just open the MS Paint.
Look at this one. So have you seen the table, right? So how to create the table? So using border, width and height, using the table text. So here I'm just draw this table here. Look at this one. So I'm just draw this table. This table having, so here again, I'm taking the rectangle. So here I'm taking the rectangle. So after that, I'm taking this, I'm changing this color for this one. See, look at this one. So they're having, look at this one. So they're having here. So we can create this one also using these. They're having the two rows, each row having the TD and TD. Now look at this one. I'm just taking this line here. So we just draw this line here. Look at this one. So how can you possible to create this type using in a, how can you create these tables using the HTML? Look at this one. In the above, they're spanning the two columns. They're spanning the two columns here. So for the spanning the two columns, so here we need to create. So first spanning of this column. So here first we can go for this call span. Let's just create the H1 here. So spanning multiple rows. Multiple rows and columns. For spanning of these columns, we can use this call span. Here I'm taking the H2 as I'm taking the call span. So call span here. For this call span, we need to create the table here. First, we can create the table. So here creating the table. In that we can take the TRs. So in this TR, we can take the TDs here. So I'm taking the TR and TD here. Now we can run this one on the browser. So before going to run, we can give the border itself. So here I'm border, I'm taking 2. So here we just give the height and width here. Width, I'm taking 300. Or I can take width, I'm taking the 300. So height, I'm taking the 200 itself. Height, we just give 200. Now we can run this one on the browser. So look at this one. If you run this one on the browser, see, look at this one. So spanning go multiple rows and columns. So here we can use the call span. Look at this one. So here we just created the two rows here. So in this below row, like in this below row, they having one more column here. So one more column, we just copy this one. So if you run this one on the browser, so look at this one. If you run this one on the browser, this below row having the two TDs, in the above row having only one TD itself. So we need to spanning this columns entire width. So here what I have to done is for this first data, for this first table data, for the first column, we should write like call span. So here they're having the two TDs, right? So here we having the two TDs. So for two TDs, we need to write here 2. So what is the meaning of this call span 2 means? It will span the two columns. Why? Because two columns. So here they're having the two columns. Suppose they're having the three columns. They're having the three columns. So here we need to give the 3 here. So I'm just removing this one. So we need only two columns. So here, we just refresh this one. So look at this one. We just created this one. Look at this MS Paint. So we just created this here. So like this, we can create the call span. Now we can go for the row span here. So I just look at this one. I'm just taking the row span. So for this row span, I'm selecting this rectangle here. So here, we just draw the rectangle. So look at this one. I'm just drag this rectangle. Look at this one. Now we can draw this. I'm just selecting this one. I'm just draw this one. So look at this one. We can span across this rows here. How to span across this rows here? How to span across this rows? Now we just open. So we just copy this one.
So I'll just copy this entire H2. So this, I just copy this table and paste it here. Paste it. So here, for this here, we just write row span. Row span. We need to write row span.
So for row span, how will you create a row span here? See, look at this one. So here, I'm just removing this one. So they're having the two rows.
So look at this one. Just giving here for these two rows, we need to give here. Just giving here like row span two here.
Now we can run this one on the browser. See, look at this one. We just created the row span here. So if you want to this side, so we just cut this one
and we can paste it here. Just paste it here.
Now we can refresh this one. See, look at this one. They're having this side. See, look at this MS Paint. We just created the row span. So like this, we can create the row span in the row span. We can span in the multiple rows and columns in the table itself. See,
next, so we need to, so how do you create table data? So how do you insert the table data? So here, inserting the data. So inserting the data in table here.
How can you inserting the data in the table? Now, while inserting the data, we just taking them. I'm just taking the table here. So I'm just taking H1 to
inserting table data.
So inserting the table data. So here we need to create the table.
So I'm just creating the table. So for this table, so here I'm just writing align equal to center. So it gives that align equal to center. So here you just use the width here. So width, I'm taking the width as 600 and I'm taking the height here. So height, I'm just giving 700, or else we can give 500. Now look at this one. So how can you insert the data in the table? So for this table, we just write tr. So in this tr, we can write the td. So here, instead of taking the td, we can also take the th also. Here I'm taking the th. Th, I'm just taking the serial number. So what is the advantage of th means? It means table had, by default, it's in the center position. So here I'm taking serial number.
So I'm taking the serial number.
Just SN. So after that, so here I'm just taking the th. So in th name, I'm just giving the name here. Name, and I'm taking one more th. So here I'm taking one more th.
For this th, we just write email here.
Just write email.
So email. Look at this one. Tr th. Now here I'm just taking one more tr. So there the th having the three columns, right? So for these three columns, we're taking the TDs. So first column having the serial number, I'm taking the one here. I'm taking one here. So I'm just copying this one. I'm taking the two here.
So here, for this name, I'll just give some Robert.
So I'm just giving the name as a Robert. So here we have a TD. So I'm just giving the Robert a Robert.
I'm taking 356@gmail.com. Now we just created a mail here.
If you run this one on the browser,
just refresh this. We can run this one on the browser. Look at this one. So go to this browser. Just refresh this browser. So they're having the date table. So with the data here. So look at this one. They're having the table with the data. So here, what's happening here means, so we're just giving the table itself, but we didn't give the table border. So here I'm just giving the table border. So I'm taking the border. So I'm just giving the border equal to 2 here. Now, so we just run this one on the browser. Look at this one. If you run this one, so the table having, so it will take the entire width, it will occupy. So here we have only one record is there. So we need to enter so much of records here. So I just copy this one. So here we just pasted. We can take more records. We just paste it here. So here I just copy this one. So I'm taking so much of records. So I just insert this multiple records here. So look at this one. I'm just inserting multiple records. So I'm taking a few more. Now we can run this one on the browser. See, look at this one. So you are inserting the multiple data here. Look at this one. They're having. So if you want to make this center, see, look at this one. So we have. So if you want to make the center, we need to write align equal to center. So look at this one, the table TRs having likely, we can having 10 TRs is there. So it is difficult to write for the 10 TRs align equal to center. But we have the CSS property that we can take them here. Just take it. So we have a CSS property. So here I'm taking, look at this one. So here I'm taking, so I'm just taking style tag. This is the internal style sheet. For this internal style sheet, I'm taking TR. So for this TR, we need to write here text align center. So I'm just writing the text align center. Now we can refresh this one on the browser. So look at this one. If you refresh this one on the browser, so on the TR, it will make the center. So like this, we can insert the data, inserting the table data. So we can move this table to center position, right? We just remove this table here. We just move the center position. We don't want the center position here. So for making the center, we can use the align center. Now you can refresh this one. So look at this one. For inserting the table data here. Look at this one. So we need to give caption for this table. We need to give caption for the table. So here, so for caption for the table, we have used in this available line, we have a caption tag. So we have caption tag. So caption tag is to give the table caption, to give the caption for the table here. Look at this one. In this caption, we need to write for the customer details. So we just write the customer details here. So here, just write the customer details. So here I'll just write, so we can write the student details. Now we can run this one on the browser. We just refresh on this browser. So there you get caption here. Like this, we can get the caption for the table here. This table having, so we have a table having specifies, define the like table having the specific structure. So what are the structures can follow the table here? So table structure is follows. So how can you follow the table structure? So here I'm just open this. So for following the table structure, so we have, so table head, t head stands for table head. So here we have the body. So it specifies that the table having this layout, like table following a table structure layout. So here t4. So like this, the table having this structure. So here I'm just opening this Visual Studio. So here we need to create table structure here. So for this table structure, so here I'm just taking the H1. So we have table structure. For this table structure, how can you follow this table structure? Just write that table here. So table. So table here. So for this table, we just write border. Border, I'm writing one. So here we just give height 300, and also can take the height equal to 400. So just write width equal to, so here we just write width equal to 500. Now we just created the tr. So instead of tr, we can create the th here. For this th, I'm taking that th here. So here I'm just giving the name. So here I'm just giving the subject, and here we just give the marks here. So look at this one. This tr can be placed inside of this structure. So here I'm taking the t head. So t head, in this t head, I just cut this tr. We just cut this tr and paste it inside of this th. Paste it inside of th here. Now we need to create the table body here. So for this table body, we create the t body here. Instead of t body, we need to create tr. So here for this tr, I'm just creating the td. So why? Because we having three tds here. So we have three tds. For three tds, so here we just give name as William. So we just give the name as William. And subject, so I'm just copying this one. So here they have a subject. I'm taking the English here, so I'm taking English. So William got the marks 90, or else he got the 90 here. Now I just take the record and fill it to 10 records here. I'm just giving 10 records. Just pasted this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I just fill in 10 records. So after the body, you just give the T foot here. So in this T foot, I'm just giving. So total. So here I'm just giving the td. So in this td, there you got total. So here we just giving, I'm taking one more td. So I'm just giving all here. Total mark. So here just give the grade as A, and we take the td here. For this td, just write here, I'm just giving 900. Now we can run this one on the browser. So just run this one on the browser. So for this table, we can add the table structure. So here we just run this one on the browser. Look at this one. So if we refresh this one and go down here, so look at this one. This table having the structure like name, subject, and marks here. So like this, we can create the table structure here. So like this, we can create table structure. So for this table structure is created, right? So we having, for this tables, we having one more concepts like, so cell padding and cell spacing. So how can you create this cell padding and cell spacing? So look at this one. So I'm just taking here. So I'm taking H1, so cell pad. For the cell padding.
Cell padding here. What is meant by cell padding? What is the difference between cell padding and cell spacing? Padding means inner space. Inner space. So cell padding is the padding between this content and the border is a cell padding. Cell means inside of table we can place the cells. So instead of we can take the TDs, right? We can call it as a table cell here. So how can you create the cell padding and cell spacing? Here I'm taking the table. Look at this one. I'm just taking the table here. The table I'm taking the TR. So inside of TR I'm taking the TDs. So I just taking the three TDs here. So here again we take the TR. So inside of that we can take the three TDs. So I'm just copy this one. I'm taking the three TDs. Now here for this one, we just apply border. So we just apply the border. Border equal to one. So for this border, I'm just giving up one here. So after that, I'm just taking this width here. So width, we just take the width as 400. So height, I'm taking the 400. Height, I'm taking the 400 here. Now look at this one. If you run this one on the browser, we just run this one on the browser. So go to the browser and refresh this one. So look at this one. We go down here. So there you get the cell padding here. What is going to be padding here? Look at this one. I didn't give the height and width for this table. I'm just removing this one. So here, I just remove this height and width here. I'm just removing this height and width. So we just remove this one. So we just remove this one. Look at this one. If we run this one on the browser, run this one on the browser. See, look at this one. The table having nothing here. It will display small here. So in this one, I'm just giving this here. I'm just taking down cell padding here. For the cell padding, we just give 40 pixels or else 50 pixels. I'm just giving the 50 pixels here. So look at this one. So look at this one. We just refresh this one. See, this means it will increase the padding here. So here we just increase this padding. Open this Visual Studio. We just increase this padding to here. I'm just giving 90 pixels. So we just refresh this one. So look at this one. Then you get 90 pixels padding. That is, it will increase the inner space here. What is meant by cell spacing? Cell spacing. So here I just mention cell spacing. Cell spacing means space between the cells. Space between the cells, we can call it as cell spacing. So here I'm taking cell spacing. Cell spacing equal to, so I'm taking the 40 pixels. Now we can run this one on the browser. If you run this one on the browser, so look at this one. If you refresh this one, so there you get the space here. So evenly there you get the space for these tables. So like this, we can apply the cell padding and cell spacing here. Now, so here we just created this one, right? Cell padding and cell spacing. So how can you apply the background colors for the table cell? How can you apply the color for table cell? So here, applying the color for table cell. So we just copy this. Just copy this and paste it here. Now we just write applying the color for table cell. Applying the color for table cell here. So applying the color for table cell. How can you apply the color for table cell? Look at this one. So in this TR, we're just giving the style tag. So I'm taking the style tag here. So in the style tag, we can give the background color. Background color. So look at this one. I'm just giving the blue here. Now you can refresh this one. If you like the style for this TR, what will happen? It will take down. See, if you refresh this one, go down here. See, look at this one. There you get all the TDs will be taken as blue color. So if you don't want to like this, so we need to give the different colors. For giving the different colors, so here we can take this inline style. So So here we can take the inline style. In the style, we can write the background color, and we can write Quora. Now we just take one more style in the inside of TD. We can take one more style. So here I'm just writing the background color. So instead of color, we can write dark green. Next, we can take style tag. So we can take the style. So background color. So here I'm taking a dark. So we just run this one on the browser. Look at this one. So like this, we can create. So we can create the boxes here. So we just remove this border here. We just remove the border. Look at this one. It's look like. We just remove this border. Just refresh this one. So look at this one. We are creating the table cells. So for this table, we can create the layouts also. So for creating the layouts, table is not at all recommended. So we can use the div tags. We can use the division tags creating the table here. So for this table, we have one more concept is that is the inner tables. How can you create the inner tables? This inner tables will help to create the how to create the calendar using the table tag. So here we have the call group is there. So look at this one. So we need to apply the rows. We need to apply the rows for this color. So what about the columns? We want to apply the columns as a similar color. For the two columns, we need to apply the similar color. What will happen? So here, look at this one. So it will apply the color for only the rows. So what is the syntax for writing down? What is the syntax for writing the columns to applying the similar color? So here we have for the similar colors. So we have a call group is it. Call group is a tag which will give the similar color for columns. So here I'm just writing the H1. For this H1, just applying the call group. So applying the call group here. So call group, I just take in the table. So here we just write the border. So in this border, we can write like, but I'll just give the 3 pixels. So here we just give, so height, I'm taking the height as 400, and I'm taking the width. So width as I'm taking the 300 here. Look at this one. I'm taking the height and width 300 and 400. Now, so here we just created the TR tag. So in this TR tag, we can create the table data. I'm just copying these three data here. Now we just copy this TR. So here I need to create 10 rows. So we just create the 10 rows here. So copy this one and paste it here. So I'll just make it into 10 rows. So here I'll just take, just copy this one. Now, so we can run this one on the browser. You can run this one on the browser. Look at this one. So if you run this one on the browser, we go down here. So they're having a table here. For this table, so we need to apply the similar color for these two rows. Remaining will be different color. So look at this one. For applying these two similar color, what will happen? So here, see. So if you want to apply this similar color, so look at this one. One column, two column, three, four, five, six. So like this, we need to write the styles for 20 times to avoid the problem. To avoid this one, so we have call group is there. So how to apply the call group here? Just here
just go to here, just write, take the call group. So just a call group here, call group close. Inside of this call group, we can take the column here. In this call, we can specify the span tag. The span indicated that how many columns do you want to apply the color here. So for the span, you just write, I'm just writing the two here. Two is that we can span the two columns and giving the color. So here is a simple, we just write the style tag. Inside of style tag, we can give the background color. So we can apply the background color. So here I'm just taking the orange red. So I'm just creating the orange red. Now remaining columns. So there are the three columns, right? So remaining column one. For this remaining column, we just write, we take the call here and we can take the style tag. Here, we just write the background color green here. We just write the background color green here. Now we can run this one on the browser. So look at this one. If you run this one on the browser, see there you got the, so there you got the column group. So like this, we're having the column group in the table. So like this, we can apply the same color for columns, and the remaining color we can set for whatever it is. So like this, we can apply the call group in the HTML tables. So here for the tables, we have a rules is there. So rule attribute. What is the use of this rule attributes? This is the rules. So rule is an attribute used in the HTML. This HTML table tag, rule attribute used to specify that. So which part you want, like which part inside of this borders should be visible. Like you can visible on this rows, none, group, like this. So here we have a values like, so we have a values like none here. So we just write none. We can write the groups, we can write the rows, we can write the columns, and we can write the all here. So like this, we're having the values in the rule set. How can you take this rules here? Look at this one, none, it does not create any type. If you write the rules equal to none, it does not create any type here. If you write a rules equal to groups, it creates the lines between rows and column group. It will create the rows and column group. If you write the rows here, it creates the line between the rows. And if you write the columns, it will create the line between the columns. If you write the all means, it will create the line between rows and columns. Just we can see the example for this table. So how can you apply these rules in the table itself? Look at this one. Go down here, we just take the rules here. So here I'm taking the h1. So for this h1, setting up rules attribute. So for this rules attribute, so here I'm just taking the table. So for this table, we just give the border. So we just taking the border. So I'm taking the one here. So after that, I'm taking the width and height. Width, I need 300, or else we can give the 200. And height, I need 200. So here we just type 200. Look at this one. So inside of this one, we just create the tr. So we need a tr here. After that, we need to tds. So in this, I'm just creating the tds. Tds, I'm just giving the name. So name, I'm just taking here. So here I'm just giving the x, y, z. So here just give x, y, z gmail.com. So z at the rate gmail.com. So I'm just providing this one. I just copy this TRs. We just copy this TRs. Look at this one. We just copy this TRs and paste it here. Now we just paste it here. Look at this one. We just pasted here. If we run this one on the browser, look at this one. If you run this one on the browser, see the table having, setting up the rules attribute, the table having the width and, so sorry, table having the border here. I just remove this border here. We just remove the border. I don't want to set the border here. Now just remove the border if you run this one on the browser. just run this one on the browser. So look at this one. We'll just highlight this one. See, look at this one. If you go down here, so table having, look at this one. Table having nothing border here. So for this setting the border. So here we told you that. So we have the rules, right? So here I'm just taking the rules here. So here I'm taking the rule. So rules equal to. So here I'm taking groups here. Groups. So if you run this one on the browser, so nothing will display, right? So we just give the, so here or rows here. So if you run this one, so you look at this one. If you run this one here, so there you get the rows here. So if you run this, if you remove this one, so we have columns, or else we can leave calls here. Now we just run this one on browser. So you look at this one, there you get the column here. So there you got column here. So if you want all, so if you want all here, so we just write, go to here. So here we just write all here. We just write all. We can take all here. Yes, we can refresh this one. So look at this one. They mention columns and rows. So like this, they're having here. So the these tables, for these tables, we just created like we want to create some background. Some like we can create the backgrounds. We can create them. Like we can create the background image. We can place the text on it using this table tag itself. So here I'm just look at this one. I'm just taking table here. So next I'm just taking the new program. So just giving table background. So I'm just taking the table background. So here, so we're taking. So here was just save as a file. So here we can save with HTML. Save this one. Now we just give. So here we just give table background. Like banner text, we need to create a banner text. We using table banner. So I just give banner here. So I'm just taking the table instead of table. I will just take the tr. So here we just follow the td itself. Now for this table, just giving. So here I'm taking the border. So we don't want this border here. I'm taking the width. So width I'm taking. Or else if you want to give the inner instead. So look at this one. So I'm just removing this one. So here. So we just take the internal style sheet. So here I'm just taking the internal style sheet. I'm taking the table tag. This is a tag selector. So for this table tag, we need to write board like. So here I'm just giving width. So width I need 100%. So it will occupy the 100%. I'm just taking the height. So height I'm taking the 500 pixels. Now here I'm just giving the background color. Background color. So for this background color, just give. So I'm just taking the indigo. Now we can run this one on the browser. So look at this one. So there you get the background here. So for this background, we need to give some text here. So instead of td, we just give the h1. So I'm taking the h1. So here, welcome to hello. Or else you can write cool nature. I'm just write cool nature. So for this cool nature, we need to apply the style one. So first we need to run this one on the browser. So if you run this one on the browser, look at this one. So there is the text here. So for this text, we just write here. So here I'm just writing the text align setup. Text align
Now you can refresh this one on the browser. Look at this one. So there you get the text here. For this text, we need to write. So we need to write some styles here. I'm just writing the H1. For this H1, so here I'm writing the color white here. So color, I'm writing the white color. Now we just apply the font size. I'm taking 60 pixels. Or else you can take 70. And we can take the font weight. Font weight 900, 800. Now we just run this one on the browser. Look at this one. So they're having the text. So like this, we can create the text. So just create a text using the table tag. So in the next class, we should learn how to apply the like background image. So how can you create the inner list, like inner tables? How can